the Winpei Fantasy Novels series. Coiling Dragon, also known as Panlong, by IE Tomatoes. Please support the author by buying the original book on the link below. Book 6, The Road to Revenge, Chapter 31, Won't Accept It. As I suspected, this genius of the Baruch clan is indeed capable of dragon forming. Although it isn't quite the same as the Dragonblood Warriors of record, despite his youth, he already has the power of a warrior of the 9th rank. The Dragonblood Warriors live up to their reputation as one of the four supreme warriors. The Holy Emperor of the Radiant Church, Hayden's, Hating Sea, had a hint of a smile on his face as he watched the going-ons below. The 1,000-plus casualties below and the blood-stained earth wasn't enough to make the Holy Emperor's heart quiver even slightly. "Kaiser, stop him!" Clade shouted frantically. Clade had never imagined that despite being in possession of a fate god, that he would be beleaguered to this extent. What's more, it was within the holy capital of Fenlai City. "Yes, Your Majesty," Kaiser called out in response, while sweeping his great sword towards Linley. Linley didn't try to defend against this attack at all. "Even if I have to take this blow head on, I am going to kill Clade first." The death of his parents had filled Linley with boundless hatred towards Clade. Only by killing Clade would he be satisfied. Otherwise, even if he died, he would be unsatisfied. Thud. The great sword slammed against Linley's body. Linley had been planning to take this blow head-on, but he suddenly realized that, bizarrely, this actually wasn't an attack against him at all. This blow was used to block Linley's charging momentum, while at the same time, Kaiser took advantage of the counterforce to knock himself flying towards Clade at an astonishing speed. Swish. Libby once more charged towards Clade. Bam! That great sword sliced through the air, blocking Bibi's way. Bibi used his fierce claws to exchange a vicious blow against the great sword. Clang! Bibi only felt a fiery aura emanate from the surface of that great sword, while at the same time, a fierce gust of battle chi raged towards him. Bibi immediately dodged quickly, but nonetheless that fiery battle chi struck his body. However, relying on his astonishing defensive abilities, Bibi only somersaulted through the air once before landing on the ground again. Kaiser stood in front of Clade, staring coldly at Linley and Bibi. "Boss, this guy is really tough." Bibi's fur was standing straight up, and he stared fixedly at Kaiser. Linley could also sense Kaiser's power. In terms of speed, Kaiser wasn't a single bit slower than him, and when he struck with his sword, his speed was even more astonishing. This Kaiser was a true, full warrior of the 9th rank, with significant experience as well. "Who are you? Why are you trying to kill His Majesty?" Sword in hand, Kaiser stared coldly at Linley. Linley didn't speak. Tapping his waist, the blood-violet god sword once more appeared in his hands. At the same time, Linley immediately utilized the wind style supporting spell, Supersonic. A supersonic spell of the 7th rank was still capable of raising Linley's speed a bit. A double expert, both Magus and Warrior. The expression on Kaiser's face changed. "Clade," Linley's guttural voice rang out. Right now, there were a group of warriors surrounding Clade, but as far as Linley was concerned, aside from that Kaiser, none of them were capable of opposing him. Swish! Linley furiously stomped the ground, causing the ground to split and crack. Relying on that powerful counterforce, Linley transformed into a merciless black blur and shot straight towards Clade. Whoosh! Bibi, being spiritually linked with Linley, shot out at the same time. Kai. Kai. The blood-violet god sword transformed into a violet blur of light, piercing directly at Kaiser. With a flip of his wrist, Kaiser's huge sword moved with surprising agility to block Linley's blood-violet. But just at that moment, That previously ramrod stiff blood violet god's sword suddenly curved, avoiding Kaiser's sword and thrusting directly at Kaiser. It was too close. Kaiser didn't have the chance to dodge at all. Bam. 3 centimeters away from Kaiser's body, the blood violet god blade suddenly came to a halt, ramming against a layer of blazing red battle chi that was sprung up to protect Kaiser. As a warrior of the 9th rank, Kaiser was incredibly strong, even a bit more so than Linley. This blow having failed, Linley didn't hesitate in the slightest, charging directly towards the nearby clade. Halt! Kaiser let out a low shout, about to move to block Linley. But from the corner of his eyes, Kaiser noticed a black blur suddenly arrive at the back of his neck. Kaiser knew exactly how terrifying this unique magical beast could be, and he didn't dare to use his battle chi to forcibly block its fierce claws. Kaiser hurriedly and agilely pivoted to dodge, putting some distance between him and Bibi. Flipping the great sword in his hand again, he chopped directly at Bibi. "Kaiser, come save me!" Clade called out frantically. Kaiser couldn't help but grow anxious. Both Linley and this terrifying magical beast had, without question, the power of a combatant of the 9th rank. What's more, that magical beast of Linley's possessed both incredible agility and terrifying defense. Kaiser was confident in his ability to deal with one, but dealing with two was a major headache. Slash. As the blood violet god's sword cut through the air, it left behind a trail of severed limbs and sprays of blood. Linley's dark gold eyes were fixed firmly upon Clade, and he charged towards Clade at high speed. Everyone who sought to block him was bisected by the blood violet god's sword in Linley's hands. Blood had already dyed every inch of Linley's black scales. With each step he took, he killed 10 people. Slash. After chopping away the last two warriors guarding Clade, Linley charged directly towards Clade. Don't kill me. Clade was now truly afraid. Kaiser was still being entangled by that astonishingly durable baby, and simply wasn't going to be able to come rescue him. As for the other warriors, they were nothing more than an afterthought to Linley. The power of Linley in his complete dragon form was enough that he would only fear a combatant of the same level. Even most warriors of the 9th rank would not be enough to make Linley afraid. Clade, die. This time, Linley didn't use his sword. With his right claw, he swiped viciously at Clade's neck. He wanted to rip Clade to death with his own hands. Ah! Clade hurriedly flew backwards at high speed, falling against a man-made hill. But with a single twitch of his legs, Linley once more appeared in front of him. Those fierce claws arrived directly in front of Clade's eyes. Father. Mother. I've finally avenged you. Linley's heart was shaking, and he brought his right claw down with force. The totally unprotected Clade, in front of Linley, was like a toothless, clawless animal. Clade's eyes were filled with terror and disbelief. Through Yuum. An extremely strange vibration suddenly emanated from the sky. In the blink of an eye, it totally surrounded Linley, making him feel as though he was sunken in quicksand. His entire body had been bound, and he couldn't use any more force with his right claws. If Linley were to use just a bit more force, he would be able to sever Clade's neck. But Linley wasn't able to move at the slightest. Clade stared, stunned, and then he exulted wildly. Ha dot ha 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 ha. Clade began to laugh loudly, and then he slowly retreated several steps before raising his head to stare at the sky. At this moment, a white-robed figure slowly floated over from up above in the sky. It was His Holiness, the Holy Emperor Hydens. Your Holiness. Clade immediately bowed respectfully. All of the warriors nearby, Kaiser included, were stunned. But then immediately, They all bowed very respectfully and called out respectfully, "Your Holiness." The highest authority within the Holy Union. The man with the authority to depose a ruler from his rule. The Holy Emperor, Hydens, had appeared. The Holy Emperor walked one step at a time towards Linley, and as he did, Linley suddenly felt as though he had escaped from the quicksand and could now move. But facing the Holy Emperor's gaze, Linley only felt his heart quiver. "Your Holiness." At this time, another squad rushed over, with two cardinals leading them, along with several executors from the ecclesiastical tribunal. "Heathen." Guillermo, seeing the totally dragon-formed Linley, was the first to speak, his face changing. The Holy Emperor Hydens calmly glanced at Guillermo. Guillermo instantly fell silent, not daring to make another sound. "Get out." Linley's guttural voice rang out, causing the Holy Emperor Hydens to look at Linley with some surprise. Despite being affected by the power of his presence, this man still was resisting. Hydens knew very well that his presence was even more powerful than the presence of most saint-level combatants, because Hydens was carrying several valuable treasures of the Radiant Church on him. "Surrender," Hydens spoke. "Whoosh." Linley suddenly moved, transforming into a blur as he flew towards Clade, while striking in an arc towards Clade with that iron whip-like draconic tail. Without question, the terrifying power of Linley's tail was enough to kill Clade with one blow. Hydens suddenly made a waving gesture with his right hand. Whap! Linley's body was sent flying far away, slamming into a distant man-made hill. Rocks shattered, and blood began to seep out all across Linley's body. From this single blow, his astonishingly sturdy scales had been shattered to the point of allowing blood to be drawn. Hydens glanced at Guillermo. Guillermo understood what Hydens wanted. He shouted an order to the executors of the ecclesiastical tribunal. "Take this demon away." Instantly, four executors charged towards Linley. "Boss." Bibi's voice rang out in Linley's mind. Linley was half kneeling against the man-made hill, and blood was dribbling out of his mouth. "Bibi. Leave. Leave now. While they haven't noticed you, leave." "I won't leave." Bibi was crouching off in the distance behind the corner of a wall, but continued to mentally converse with Linley. "No. With the Holy Emperor present, we no longer have any chance at all. He hasn't noticed you yet, so you have a chance to slip away. Bibi, leave now. I must kill that Clade. Even if I die, I need you to help me kill him. If even you are caught, in the future I will have no chance at all. Boss. Leave. Or else, even if I die, I won't forgive you." Linley roared mentally. In the corner of that wall, Bibi stared at Linley, his little eyes filled with fury, grief, and an unwillingness to depart. "Leave now." Linley mentally howled with fury at him. At this moment, those four executors had walked to Linley's side and reached out, intending to subdue Linley. But that half-kneeling Linley suddenly rose to his feet, like a praying mantis attacking from ambush. Swish! A violet light flashed. All four of them were bisected at the waist. "Die." Linley charged towards Clade once again. The expression on Clade's face changed. "Even if I die, I will kill you first." Linley howled with rage. Harm... The eyes of the Holy Emperor Hydens flashed coldly, and he let out a sneer. His right hand slapped in Linley's general direction, and suddenly, a terrifyingly powerful force appeared out of nowhere, surrounding and pressing down Linley from all sides. Linley felt as though an enormous mountain had just slammed onto his body. Bam! Linley was slammed into the ground. Crack! Linley felt that the bones in his body were suddenly broken in over 10 different places. Totally paralyzed, he lay there on the ground, unable to move again. Nobody, no matter how strong, would be able to move with so many bones broken. "Take him away," Guillermo once again ordered. "Boss." Seeing the sorry state Linley was in, tears were flowing down Bibby's face. Linley was lying on the ground, totally paralyzed. All the bones in his arms, legs and ribs were shattered. He couldn't move at all. The black scales covering him were in even worse shape, and blood flowed out from the flesh beneath the scales, dyeing his entire body red. "Boss. Leave. Bibby, leave." Linley was mentally roaring with rage. Several executors of the ecclesiastical tribunal roughly lifted Linley up. Perhaps it was because they had just seen Linley murder four of their colleagues, but their hands were not gentle, and as they carried him, they didn't pay any attention to his wounds. This sort of carrying method caused Linley's entire body to be filled with agony. As he was lifted and carried away, Linley continued to stare unblinkingly at Clade. "Ha ha, ha ha." Clade began to laugh again. Staring at Clade with those dark gold eyes, Linley roared furiously, "If I don't kill you, I won't rest. Even in death, I won't accept it." Linley's voice made the heart of that far-off Bibby quiver. Hearing these words, Clade's heart couldn't help but quiver as well. "I won't accept it." Two trails of tears cascaded down from Linley's eyes. He had been so close to victory. But in the end, he had still failed to kill Clade. Thank you for listening the audiobook series by Win Pei. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for the new updates of your favorite audiobooks. Please support the author by buying the original books in the description. Love and peace. Win Pei.